Okay, I know I was supposed to wasn't start until 8:15, but I'm getting on a few minutes early to see if I can get some folks on. Hey, Mary. Hey, Roxanna. Hey, Tony. While we're waiting, I'm gonna give it, let's see, what time is it? Anyway, give it just a few minutes. How was everybody's weekend? I know, and some of you are not gonna have any idea what I'm talking about, but I know I had planned to do the Halloween look, but it got a little more busy than I thought this weekend, so I'm still going to try to get to that sometime this week, quick. Hey, Peyton. Oh, I want to tell you about something, too. Y'all know the little nail things? If you ever went and got your nails done, you know that they use those nail things to cut your nails down instead of nail clippers. I got some and they're awesome. They work. Mom used them on her regular nails, like her regular nails. They work on everything. But I don't know about you, but it's a lot more simple to use one of these than regular nail clippers. And it was like $4 maybe. I don't know. I just thought that was pretty cool. And they're made pretty well. So it was like three something. Can y'all hear that music? I don't like it too loud where you can't hear me over it, but I like a little something in the background. Hey, Misty. Hey, Kara. This, I did, went ahead and did my right hand because I didn't want to be on here forever. And, it's the harder one to do. Not as hard as when you're doing nail polish, but it's still hard to do when you're right-handed. Your right hand. But I did go ahead and do that one. I did decide to do the purple glitter on my point finger. I don't know. I always like an accent nail for some reason. But anyway, I still gotta, like, do a little do here and there. But I think they're awesome. And I didn't really want to do the acrylics. Hold on, this is bothering me. I didn't really want to do the acrylics because I was liking how long my real nails were. But let me tell you what happened to those. I decided to try and shape them. But before I realized what I was doing, I made them all too thin when I was shaping them. And, they started bending, like literally bending. And hey, Brittany. And so they were just started breaking off really easy. But I also know there's a bunch of ladies, some of y'all that are watching now. It's a little loud. Okay. Thanks, Kara. That should be a little bit better. Hey, Heather. Hey, Anna. But I know a lot of the girls that I have talked to don't like the shape of their nails. They don't like how short they are, which I'm going to be honest with you. I don't like short nails either. Most people don't. Hey, Mama. But I also know how bad when you do acrylics, like when you go to the salon, how bad it makes your real nails, like it damages them if you do it over and over and over again. Which anything you do, even the strips, your nails need a break. They need to breathe. But so I decided since they were all breaking off anyway, and there were so many girls asking me or wanting to know about the acrylics, I decided to go ahead and try it myself, and I actually had a really, really fun time doing them myself and shaping them and all that. It's not as hard as I thought. And then putting them on there is honestly about the same as putting them on your regular nails, and it's nail polish, so it's not like it's not gonna stick as good as it does to your natural ones, because it's nail polish. That's what the strips are, and they're like 95% dried. Like when you put them on, when you open the package out. Sorry, that was a advertisement. How's the music now, y'all? Is it too low, too loud? Hey, Savannah. Okay, what time is it? 8:13. But anyway. Well, I got some coke in my bourbon, surfing a room like Sway's. No, I ain't drunk, I'm okay. I just picked something. Sorry if y'all don't like country music. I just picked something that was, you know, kid friendly. All ears friendly. And I honestly only know country music to be that way. Hey, Lauren. Alright. So, I'm going to do the accent one first. Hey, Ashley. Alright, so when you get your strips, they come in. I already have it open. So, they come in the little package like this. And it comes with your strips, obviously. A little alcohol pad. Because you don't have to use that if you don't want to. But if you don't, just make sure your nails are really, really clean before you decide to put the strips on. And it also comes with this little, I have Prego brains. I forget some stuff. Nail file. And they actually work pretty good. They get in good, like, up in the corners where the big ones won't get out. And when I start doing this, y'all, I'm actually going to move my phone. And it's going to look kind of weird because I'm going to try to set it up on something. Can you hear it? It sounds really low to me, but I've got it, like, right beside my phone. So, it's probably higher sound to y'all. But, anyway, it comes. It tells you in here what the strips are about. If y'all have never tried the Colorstreet, it's 100% real nail polish, no dry time. You just peel them and apply them. Easy removal with polish remover. That's it. That's all it takes, polish remover. There's no special thing to buy or anything like that. It comes with a base coat, your color, and your top coat. So you don't have to apply a top coat. But something else I think I'm going to try. I'm not going to do it on here because I haven't made my mind up yet. But I bought some matte top coat. I like the matte more than I do the shiny stuff. Which I like the shiny stuff, just I like the matte too. So I think I'm gonna try that on a couple of them and just see what it looks like. But I don't know yet, so I'm not doing it over here. But anyway, I think that's it. I thought I was gonna tell y'all something else. But, oh yeah, and it comes with the instructions on this little tab. If you open it. Anyway, also, if you have not tried Colorstreet, if you have not tried it, put me in the comments if you want a free sample. And then I'll message you later to get your address where I can send it to you. That's if you haven't tried them. Hey, April. Okay, let's get started here. And I've done cleaned my nails, so I don't have to do that part, but make sure you do that before you put your strips on. I'm going to try to keep all my trash in one spot. I don't know why I did that first. Oh, I was doing that. I'm telling y'all, Frigo brain. It's not a good thing. Okay, I'm doing my... Oh, y'all, crap. Hold on. Okay. I'm fixing to turn my camera around because I can't do like this. I mean, I can, but it's going to be hard for me to see it doing it like this, and it's going to be hard for you to see it. So, let me turn my camera around so y'all can see good. Okay. I hope it stays focused right. And y'all, it looks kind of weird to me because I'm like looking through my camera and I've never done it this way before, so. So it might, oops, put that on upside down. So y'all just bear with me because I'm doing this looking through my camera and it's weird. Okay, so you just pick, I only have one of these out because I'm only using one on each hand as an accent nail. But, and also if you don't end up using all of them and you want to save the rest, which I don't see why you wouldn't, but you want to save the rest, you can put them back in the little clear package. And some people use a straightener, some people use like a little food processor thing. Honestly, I just use a lighter and okay. I'm trying to look around it cause it's just easier for me to see. But, what you do is you find a way to seal the end, of that little thing. Of here, I'll show you this little clear part that you cut open, take the nails out of. You just find a way to seal it. I just burn the end and then mash it together. That way, I can save what's left. All right. So I know it's kind of focusing in and out. It's being crazy, but anyway. So that's all you do. You just peel it off. Make sure you you got a size it and everything, make sure it fits, and make sure if it does get on your cuticle right there, it's okay. I mean, it's not that big of a deal. You can get it off, and it doesn't take any special tools to do this. I don't know why that thing keeps doing ads, but and then if there's any excess like this, I'll do it when I get done. I just take a nail file of any kind, it doesn't matter, and then you'll go up under and you'll file like that. Hold on, let me use this little one because that I don't have a whole lot of room between my phone camera and the table, so I'm gonna use this little one since it's shorter. Okay, and you just do like that, and you file down. Always file down, which I'll do that whenever I get the other ones on. Okay, so now this is your line of strips. I've already used the other one on my other hand, and you just see how they're going to fit. Now, I don't know which way everybody likes to do it. It looks to me like this is supposed to be the base part. I do it either way sometimes. But I always, I have learned as many times I've done these, I always go with a bigger size because you can always, it's always easier to take some off than to have to restart your whole strip. Oh, I didn't even see that. Okay. All right. I'm going to do my pinky first. Hold on. I've got to figure out a better way to get my camera on these things. Hold on, y'all. I'm going to make sure this fits first. It's hard to see that up under the camera.
Okay.
Okay, it fits. All right. Okay, so you have your strip. You pull the clear part off. I'm trying to keep all my trash in one place. And then you, that little tab right there. And y'all feel free to share. Because I know a lot of people love these Colorstreet nails, which I myself do. But honestly, before I decided to start doing this, it seemed complicated to me. But it's really not. Okay, it's hard to do my pinky because I can't see. Okay, hold on. It's usually not this difficult, y'all. It's just, it's hard for me to see. Hold on. I may just have to do the pinky without putting it in front of the camera because it's so hard for me to see. And I don't have a lot of room to work with. Hold on. Let me see something. Okay, somebody tell me if I'm upside down or how that's looking. Because I just turned it around. That way it's easier. Try and keep it where y'all can see. And there, it's really cool because if you accidentally stick it on wrong, you know, with a few seconds, you can still pull it back off and fix it. But I know a lot of people are like, I don't know how to do that. I don't want to do it myself, you know. I am going to post about something pretty awesome in my secret group. Well, it's not really a secret group because, I mean, everybody knows about it, but not everybody's in it. But I can only post certain things in that group that, like, I can't post on my page. So, y'all get in there. I'll come back and post in the comments under here. See, and you just peel, and then all that little extra on the side, you just kind of mash it down. And they also do, after a little while, they're dry, okay? You don't have to worry about that, but after a couple hours, they settle, like cure, if that's what you want to call it. So they always, honestly, to me, they always look better a couple hours later. Even more better than they do. But there you go. Okay. Alright. Now, if I can find what I did with those strips. There they are. Alright, now I'm gonna see about, I think this one's gonna work. Because I always, even if it looks like a tad bit too small, I honestly, you can stretch them, but I'd rather not. I've messed up too many like that. I don't like stretching them. I would rather just use a bigger size. So how was everybody's weekend? Okay. I've never had this shaped nail either, y'all. This is the first time I've done like the, it's supposed to be like a pointier almond shape. I really like it though. I kind of did it for like the Halloween thing, but you know. I always do the coffin. The coffin's my favorite. But I wanted to do something different, and I thought the pointy almond look was pretty cool for Halloween. Okay, see, let me see if I can do this. I'm gonna show y'all. It's barely like, And you just stretch just a little bit. You don't pull too hard, because if you pull too hard, then you're gonna rip it. There we go. Alright. I did it. I think I ripped it. I did, y'all. I ripped it. But that's kind of, I'm kind of glad that's why I did this live, because I'm showing y'all that's what happens if you stretch it too hard. You rip it. Hold on. Good thing I ripped it down there at the end so I can just turn it around. Okay. And the little bumps, like, you can rub those out, but they'll eventually settle down in. This one might just be kind of messed up, y'all, because I stretched it out, and that's why I hate stretching. That's why I'm telling you, I hate stretching them out, because some people can do it just fine. I mean, you may can do it just fine and not mess them up, but every time I've tried to stretch even a little bit, they mess up. So that's why I just always say go with the bigger size. Let me see if I can get that mesh down. But it's also not, I mean, you know, it doesn't have to be perfect. Especially your first few times doing it. This is actually on my third time doing mine. I know it don't seem, it really don't seem like it to me either, but this is only my third time doing it. Dang, that song's a little bit louder. Felt like I was having to try to talk over that. Okay. And see, when you do, you have just a little bit of excess and you just fold it over and you'll file that down later. Alright. Let's see. I like to trying to keep it in the camera, y'all. Okay. Told y'all, I have done the makeup lives before. This is the first time I have done live on my fingernails, and it's not easy. Doing them is a lot easier than doing them on, trying to do them on live. Because the camera's all funky, and I'm trying to be able to see and be able to let y'all see too. Who's playing that loud music? I mean, that loud sound. Oh, I'm using the wrong one again. Anyways, like I said, I know it seems kind of complicated, but it's really not. For me, it's a lot, like I said, it's a lot easier when I'm just doing it, like, to be doing it, not on live. But it's really cool, though, y'all. I don't have the time to go get mine done anymore. So I think I got that acrylic set. It was just the clear ones. And I think I got that for like, I know it was under $10. But you can get a lot of sets out of it. And I mean, you can shape them how you want to. You know, sit right in your living room or on your bed, or I sat on my porch and did it. Okay. Now I just got my thumb left. I know that is not going to fit my thumb. May even have to use the biggest one. Okay, yeah, see how that's, like, it's barely, looks like it's going to go on there. No, I'm not doing that. I'm going to go with the bigger one. Because don't want to have to try and stretch that one and mess it up, too. Plus, the solid jaw, they are a little bit more like, I really don't even know how to explain it. Either way, it's cool to me. I can do it right at the house. It doesn't cost near as much as going and getting them done. And now I have found out I even do the acrylics at home. If, you know, I'm not liking my nail shape or they're breaking off or whatever you want to call it. Just not, can't grow them. I know a lot of white nails I used to. And that's why they like to get their acrylics. So, now you know that that can be done. And you can still get your strips and don't have to worry about using nail polish on acrylics, because I have never liked to do that. I've done it once and I did not like it. Okay, so they're on there now. Now, let's see. I'm just gonna go up under and file down to get that extra off. And it just comes right off. And look, something else, where'd it go? These little cuticle pushers. I think that's what they're called. That's what I call them anyway. I didn't even realize I wasn't showing y'all. I'm sorry. And I always sit and play with them, like, perfect them and all that stuff or whatever. But they're literally slap on and go. I mean, even if you want to do like this stuff, the extra stuff under there, if you just got to go or you're like tired but you won't really want to have your nails done for the next day or whatever, you can leave it like that and just take it off later. And when you get, I hate that bump in there. And that's the one I messed up on trying to stretch, but it'll be okay. Anyway, when you get some excess on there, if you can't get the file to it, like normally when, if I end up having excess down here by my cuticle, I'll just take the cuticle pusher and like push down like that and it'll just come right off. But somehow I didn't really get any excess on this, on these. But y'all don't forget to share, because I know that was the one I tried to stretch. I may end up redoing that, y'all. I can't stand it. Crickets and the frogs. I named the dog. I think I named everything. Just kidding. Sorry, y'all. If y'all been, oh my gosh, if y'all been commenting, I'm so sorry. I have not even been. Give me just this second. You know what? I'll do this later. I'll do the excess later. Because it's only a few of them. Actually, that's really the only one I have left to get it off of. Trying to keep it down here at the camera. I gotta figure out a better way to do this, y'all. Where y'all can see better and I can see better. Because this is hard. Thank all y'all for sharing. You're so awesome. I really hope people that, I mean, you know, want some help, or I know there's a lot of my friends that really have been wanting to try it, but just don't, you know, don't really know how, or they want longer nails. They don't want to do it on their short nails. Okay. Okay, let's see. April, okay, I got you. I'll message you and get your address. What's busy? Thanks for sharing, Roxanna, and everybody else that shared. I seen all them shares. I'm liking that. Yep. Okay. So there they are. And these are acrylics. These are not my nails. That's what I was trying to shape my nails into, and it just didn't work. I made them too thin. They weren't really long enough when I started doing that, and I messed up, so I should have waited a little bit, but. Are you stealing my slides? But anyway, y'all, that is seriously so easy. I did not think it was. I'm telling y'all, like a year ago, maybe like a year and a half ago, I seen the Colorstreet nails for the first time, and I was like, yeah, send me a sample, let me try it out, because I like having my nails done. Don't like naked nails. I ain't gonna lie to you, my nails are dirty half the time because I have 3 kids, a bunch of dogs, a pig. I mean, you know, there's a lot of stuff, and they just get so dirty all the time. So I just don't like naked nails. But I tried them in, like, I did the sample, so I just kept watching for like a year, and I was like, man, I really need to try that stuff again, because I did not give it a good chance the first time I tried it. It worked, but I just wanted to get it done, I guess, and spend that money. But I don't have time to go do them anymore. So me being able to sit here at my kitchen table and do them myself, or on my back porch, which is usually where I do it. The kids are always outside playing. But anyway, it's not as hard as it looks. I know it looks hard. I'm sorry, y'all. I know the live, I promise you, made it look harder. That was my cat. The live made it look harder than it really is. It's really not that hard. But I always have fun doing lives. Y'all know I do. And if y'all used to watch my makeup lives, I always have fun doing lives. Speaking of, I did mention at the beginning of the video that I'm still gonna do the Mad Hatter thing. I did do it. I did like a practice run, and it looked pretty cool, but like, I just didn't have it. Just there was so much stuff that happened this weekend that I didn't think was gonna happen. But anyway, I'm gonna get it done. I promise y'all, I'm gonna get it done. But I will let y'all know the date of. I'll let you know a couple hours or something ahead of time. Anyway, if you want a sample, or you know somebody that wants to try it, and has not tried it yet, please comment me in the comments below. If you watched the replay or are watching the replay, I know y'all are not right now, but if you're watching the replay, please hashtag replay in the comments so I can know that you watched after I did live. Hey, Kelly. But if you haven't tried it yet and you want to try it, comment me below in the comments and I will send you a sample. I'll message you and get your address. But y'all, there are so many colors. There's so many solid colors. There's so many designs. There's French tips. There's white and black. And I think there's even like a little sparkly one. I haven't made sure. I've done French tips on my mom, and they actually turned out really, really good. And let me just tell y'all something else. She works in an animal shelter, like cleaning cages all day, taking dogs outside, you know, all this kind of stuff. And they lasted her. They didn't chip. They didn't do anything. Everything she puts her hands in, chemicals and all that kind of stuff, they stayed for 2 weeks. So I'm telling y'all, this is some awesome stuff. Don't have to go anywhere to do it. And I am doing something big, and it has to do with the acrylics. So if you're one of those that would rather have the acrylics, like you want to do the Colorstreet, but you want longer nails,